Now that we know how to configure our logical camera plugin, let's find out how to use the data it provides. We learned earlier that logical camera outputs model names and poses of objects. And poses contain position and orientation information. Sure, but with respect to what reference are these information defined? The pose of an object detected by the logical camera is defined in its own reference frame. Let's say, for example, logical underscore camera underscore frame. And this information is published as a ROS topic. And this ROS topic has the logical camera image message type. So if we look at the message type, we first see that it has a placeholder for a model array to store all the models it detects within its frustum. And then it has a placeholder for its own pose in the factory world. Also, the model message type has a string placeholder for the model name and a pose of the model itself. Notice here, though, that the pose placeholder is just a pose. Then this does not provide any reference information like the pose stamped message. So we as users have to process this pose information to a pose stamped message so that timing and reference frame information can be added before other modules in our ROS application can make use of this information. And that will be one of the tasks in your assignment. Let's now see what sort of contents we can expect in the logical camera image topic. We can publish the pose of all the detected objects by a logical camera by echoing the logical underscore camera topic. For example, when the logical camera is added to the factory simulation environment on top of the conveyor belt, we can see the following output. Note that I have clipped the complete content of the topic for illustration purposes. We see that the conveyor underscore belt and the conveyor underscore belt underscore fixed objects are being detected by the logical camera, and their corresponding pose information in the reference frame of the camera is available here too. Now, how does the logical camera know the names of these objects? In the model SDF files, we define model names as well. And that's what is used by the logical camera to publish the name information. Note that the logical camera plugin can also be configured to publish only object names that are known. In our case, since we also have objects on the conveyor belt that are unknown, we will leave it in the default configuration where all detected objects will be published. Just that the name of the unknown object will be updated as just an object. All right, in the next module, we will learn how to use the logical camera information in our ROS application of the factory simulation together with the ROS package TF. Come back soon to enter the world of ROS TF.